Here's an introduction to how the inverter charger's built-in BMS module communicates with the lithium battery. Crafted to address your advanced energy management needs while enhancing the security and stability of off-grid energy storage, BMS stands for Battery Management System. It is specifically designed to monitor battery packs, playing a crucial role in preventing safety hazards, prolonging battery life, and ensuring optimal performance. Epever's inverter charger devices are compatible with approximately 22 BMS manufacturers and protocols. If needed, please contact us to request the relevant documentation. Our inverter charger devices come with two types of BMS communication interfaces, RJ45 and USB. All of them need extra communication cables to connect with lithium batteries that have BMS communication interfaces. You can refer to the screenshots to choose the correct communication cable. This video will showcase the KR series monochrome screen, UC series color screen, and Epever lithium battery as examples to demonstrate the BMS setup methods for two different operating systems. While the two devices may appear similar, their operating methods are actually quite different. You'll get the hang of it intuitively later. Begin by setting up the UC series. Insert the end of the communication cable labeled BAT into the RS485 interface of the battery. Next, plug the other end of the communication cable into the BMS interface on the inverter charger device. Ensure the labels on both ends of the communication cable match the corresponding devices. If the device and battery are connected incorrectly, they will not be able to communicate. Set the battery DIP switch to 1, then turn on the battery and the device separately. Notes: the communication port pin definitions and DIP switch settings vary among lithium battery manufacturers. Customers must customize the communication cable based on the specific BMS protocol file for their lithium battery. Turn on device. Allow the device to boot up. Configure the BMS communication. This UC series features a touch screen and its operation is just like using a mobile phone. Click the gear icon located in the top right corner of the screen. Enter the initial password, 6 zeros. This will take you to the setting options interface. The inverter charger communicates with the lithium battery, requiring three key parameters to be configured: battery type, BMS activation, and BMS protocol number. They are all listed under the system section. Click the system entry to access the suboption settings. Set the battery type on the first page. Click Set. Find LFP15S. Press Enter to confirm the setting, then click Save. Note, please set the battery type according to the one you are actually using. For instance, the battery shown is a 48-volt lithium iron phosphate battery. According to the 3.2 voltage of a string of cells, 48 divided by 3.2 equals 15, so select LFP15s. If you are using our battery and are not sure about the battery type and the number of strings of cells, please contact us in time, and our professionals will help you solve such problems. After selecting the battery type, click the next page arrow at the bottom of the interface twice to access the charge and discharge management page. Swipe up the screen and stop once you reach the BMS port entry. Enable the BMS and set the BMS port to 10. Then, reboot the device. Once the device reboots, the BMS icon will appear on the main display screen. The UC series inverter charger has successfully established communication with the lithium battery. To maximize the intelligent and efficient use of the lithium battery, we can configure more detailed settings for optimal performance. The recommended items enable functions such as lithium battery protection, BMS voltage control, BMS current control method, battery charging and discharging mode, and more. Please refer to the user manual for detailed instructions on setting various parameters. Be sure to read it thoroughly before making any adjustments. Configure the KR series. Link the battery to the device using a communication cable. Power on both the battery and the device. The KR series features a monochrome screen without touch functionality. So settings and function adjustments need via the buttons located at the bottom of the screen. Press and hold the Enter key to access the password input screen. Enter the administrator password, 40 to proceed, and press it twice to access the setting parameter navigation interface. Similar to the UC series, three key parameters must be configured to enable communication between the KR series inverter charger and the lithium battery. Battery type, BMS activation, and BMS protocol number. They are found under Item 6, System Parameter Settings. Item 9, Battery Control Data Setup. We will showcase them individually. Press the down arrow to find the ninth item, then press Enter to select it. Replace the battery type with LFP15s. Note, for detailed battery string calculation methods, please refer to the UC series. Press the ESC key to go back. Find the sixth item and select it. Hold the down key, find BMS valid invalid, and change it to valid. Then update the BMS protocol to 10. Under this item, we can enable both BMS voltage control and BMS current selection simultaneously. Reboot the device after configuring the settings. The BMS icon appears on the screen. The device and battery are successfully communicating, allowing you to adjust other battery settings. Although the UC series and KR series inverter chargers use different operating systems, their approach to setting up the BMS is the same. Ensure the correct battery type is selected, BMS is enabled, and the appropriate BMS protocol number is set. If you have any questions during the setup process, please refer to the user manual, which provides detailed explanations of the various abbreviations. Sure, if you have any other questions, don't hesitate to reach out to us.